With most of the top PvP scene pretty much fully geared, we now have a pretty good idea of where the meta has evolved to and which classes and specs are outperforming others. Well, a recent PTR build has revealed that our mid-season patch, 9.0.5, will actually be shaking things up quite a bit, and it's looking like a handful of specs that have been underperforming throughout the season so far might be about to take back their throne. In this video, we'll be breaking down the upcoming patch and discussing which changes are relevant so you know exactly what to expect the moment the patch goes live. First, we've got a change to Demon Hunters, specifically to the Unbound Chaos talent, which has seen its damage increase moved up to 500% from 300. Demon Hunters currently spec into Glaive Tempest, which they use as part of their burst sequence. The issue is that enemy players can move out of it, so if you don't use it with a stun, it can be completely wasted, potentially making the talent useless at times. With the buff to Unbound Chaos, however, there's an opportunity for DHs to adopt a rather unique playstyle to set up some ridiculous burst sequences. Players can use Immolation Aura and wait 20 seconds until the buff from Unbound Chaos is just about to expire. They can then deal an insanely hard-hitting Fel Rush and combo that directly into another Immolation Aura and a second hard-hitting Fel Rush. And of course, let's not forget about the Hunt, which Demon Hunters will also be able to pair this up with, getting their Unbound Chaos buff up, using the Hunt, and then immediately following up with a Fel Rush. Altogether, this Unbound Chaos change is likely to give DHs a lot more burst potential. However, it doesn't really fix the issue that the class currently has, which is just how frail they are. Still though, this change will push DHs more in the direction of a hit-and-run class, where they can come in with huge burst and spend the rest of their time running around and focusing on staying alive. Next, we're taking a look at Resto Druids, who have received quite a substantial buff. The 12% buff to Rejuvenation is more than just a 12% buff when you consider the fact that Resto Druids play with the talent Germination, which allows them to apply 2 rejuves to each target. This alone is quite a significant increase to Resto Druid's single target and spread pressure healing, but in addition, Wild Growth has also been buffed. And although you don't necessarily prioritize keeping this up manually, it does get applied with Overgrowth, which will definitely make this cooldown more reliable for quickly picking back up people's health that have dropped. And it doesn't stop there, because on top of these already great buffs, the Druid Necrolord Covenant ability has also been buffed. Now, at face value, this buff may not seem too big, but when you consider the evolved Swarm Conduit, which also works to increase the period effects, Resto Druids are going to have a much easier time healing their teammates with just HOTS. Up until now, it just felt like Resto Druids are just ever so slightly missing out on some throughput, which would tip them over the edge and bring them up from irrelevancy in threes, being one of the best healers, and this change might just be what was needed to make this happen. We honestly wouldn't be surprised if, come patch 9.0.5, we start to see more and more Resto Druids show up at high rating in threes. Another healer receiving a handful of much-needed buffs is the Mistweaver Monk, receiving a mana reduction to both Vivify and Renewing Mist. Although it's only a 0.3 and 0.4% reduction, Mistweavers already saw a recent buff to their mana and cooldown of Life Cocoon, which has been enough to at least allow the spec to start seeing some life at high rating. In addition to these changes, Mistweavers are also receiving a buff to their legendary of choice, Clouded Focus. This buff will help to increase throughput while being yet another source of mana reduction. Still though, the spec definitely has a ton of glaring weaknesses beyond just their mana bar, so it's likely these changes to further reduce their mana consumption won't be too huge in most matchups. With that being said though, Mistweavers have been considered one of the better healers into casters, and these mana changes will probably make the spec one of the better healers into spell cleaves, which means it's entirely possible that we start to see Mistweavers pop up in the 2021 Arena World Championship circuit. But sadly, we think their weaknesses will probably prevent them from doing too well in ladder play, where they can't handpick the matchups they play. Moving on, we have yet another healer receiving some mana changes. This time, however, it's more nerfs to Holy Paladin mana. This upcoming nerf, in addition to the nerfs on February 8th, definitely makes it clear what stance the developers have on Holy Paladin mana, with it clearly being an issue that they are able to sustain for so long while also having incredible throughput. Although it's worth noting, this change definitely feels quite minor and is unlikely to make much of a difference. The next change though is definitely a big one, and that's the rework to the Divine Vision PvP talent, which is a huge indirect buff to Shadow Priests and Warlocks. With Shadow Resistance Aura gone from Divine Vision, we'll likely see a surge in Shadow Priest comps at the top of the ladder, and potentially might even start to see more Warlock comps as well. And speaking of Warlock buffs, we've finally seen Warlock concerns addressed, as they've received a much-needed buff to Demon Armor, increasing it from 90% to 120%. There's no doubt in any player's mind that this buff was necessary, given how warlocks are probably easier to kill now than ever before. The other buff to amplify curse, although not as important as the one to demon armor, is certainly a nice addition that will offer warlocks a little more outplay potential whenever they choose to use this talent. The main talking point though has to be the combination of shadow resistance aura going and the increased demon armor, as these changes alone are most likely going to be enough to start seeing warlocks perform much better than earlier in the season. The next class that we're looking at, or rather spec, is going to be assassination rogues. And given just how good the spec throughout Legion and BFA was, and the fact that it's been getting consistently buffed recently, we would not be surprised to find out that one of the developers is just all about that assassination rogue life, as the buffs are yet again continuing in this upcoming patch. This time though, instead of just seeing a direct damage buff, we're actually seeing slice and dice made available to all rogue specs, including assassination. In addition, they're getting a passive which allows them to refresh slice and dice whenever they use in Venom, essentially buffing the spec by giving it consistent access to a buff it previously didn't have. And when you pair the addition of slice and dice to an assassination rogue's toolkit with the small tweak to venomous wounds, it's entirely possible that their DPS will become much stronger and allow the spec to start flourishing in arena. It's also no secret that assassination is the easiest to play of all the rogue specs. And so, if it starts to become viable again at high rating, we definitely expect to see a huge surge on the ladder as well. However, one thing to note is that it seems Slice and Dice has actually been changed to no longer increase energy regeneration and instead will just increase attack speed. This is of course not a nerf to assassination, as they previously didn't even have access to the buff, but if this change is accurate, then it can be considered a nerf to sub and outlaw. Assassination rogues are also seeing a buff to one of their better legendaries, Doomblade, which although minor, is still a DPS increase nevertheless. The final set of class changes we're going to look at are for shamans, but the biggest ones going to Ellie shamans. They're getting a slight rework to where their damage comes from, with lava burst damage being reduced and earth shock damage being increased. It's possible that this change will affect how Ellie shamans set up their burst with echoing shock and primordial wave, and it will hurt their consistent damage a little. But it honestly shouldn't make too much of a difference, especially when you consider that Stormkeeper is largely responsible for their one-shots. One important note though is that the 10% nerf to Lava Burst is actually going to impact Resto as well, and when you consider that they actually do hit pretty hard with Lava Burst, this is definitely a meaningful nerf, even if it won't be the difference between teams winning or losing games very often. We've also seen a rather surprising change to Enhancement Shamans, with Lava Lash getting a massive 40% buff. Right now, Enhance pretty much relies entirely on Wind Fury and Storm Strike for their damage, with Lava Lash being more of an afterthought. However, this change might actually put Hot Hand ahead of Storm Flurry, which would seriously buff Enhance sustained damage. We'd say that currently Enhance doesn't do too much outside of its Doom Wind windows, but those windows are super deadly. With the Lava Lash buff, there's a chance that their consistent damage might become quite threatening, making an already S-tier spec even better. But of course, if 40% isn't enough to make a difference, this change won't really do anything, as most enhanced shamans will just stick to Storm Flurry and will end up doing a little more overall damage. And last up for Enhance, Stormkeeper has also been buffed for Enhance, as it'll make Chain Lightning do a lot more damage. But this is absolutely not something that is relevant in PvP, as Ascendance is far too good to not use given how strong your single target burst is when it's up. Oh, and real quick everyone, before we continue, we'd like to take a moment to talk about a place that you can use to up your game and improve faster than anywhere else, Skillcapped. We've pioneered educational content within World of Warcraft for over 10 years, and have spent all of that time perfecting our craft and consistently working with the absolute best players in the world to bring you the content that you need to keep up with the meta and get ahead of your peers. And with these changes coming up next patch, there's no better time to become a member and stay ahead of the meta, with up-to-date PvP guides being released every week for every class. Members also gain premium access in our Discord, which lets them gain a direct line of communication with our pros, requesting macros, downloading add-on profiles, and even submitting gameplay for review. So, if you're interested in becoming a part of our community and stepping up your game, head on over to skillcap.com/wow and sign up today. Link in the description below. All right, back to the changes. And with the class-specific ones out of the way, we've still got a handful of additional legendary changes to look at, of which only a few are relevant. First, we have Surging Shots and Latent Poison Injectors, the DPS legendaries of choice for MM and Survival Hunters, respectively. Certainly a noteworthy buff that will make the offensive parts of these specs slightly stronger, which is definitely a plus, as it's mostly offense where they lack. Next up, the recent buffs to Frost Mage are now also being paired with a handful of buffs to their legendaries, potentially giving them more offensive options outside of simply sticking to the defensive Triune Ward. Back during the beta, Freezing Winds was considered the best legendary for Frost Mages, so we definitely expect to start seeing this show up for Frost Mages that want to play a little more aggressively. And last up, a very surprising buff, which is definitely PvE oriented, is to the Exploiter Legendary, which has recently proved to be a vital part of a Venthyr Arms Warrior's kit. And while this legendary doesn't work too well in PvE, given that bosses don't spend much time in execute range, enemies are of course healed in PvP, which means that they spend more time able to be hit by Condemn, making this a very meaningful buff for Venthyr Arms Warriors, who are already proving to be one of, if not the best melee in the game right now. Alright, with the classes and legendary changes covered, let's round out the patch notes by looking at Covenant changes, the most important of which are happening to the Necrolord Covenant ability, Fleshcraft. On live servers, Fleshcraft currently offers a 20% absorb after 4 seconds and comes with no damage reduction while channeling it. This change is a huge buff to Resto Shamans, who compare it with Ancestral Gift to gain a 30% damage reduction while giving themselves a 40% absorb. This combination will make it close to impossible for Resto Shamans to die in swaps if they can preemptively pull it off or by burning their trinket to do so. And while this buff to Fleshcraft won't be enough to make other classes want to swap to Necrolords, Eli Shamans, Resto Druids, and DKs will still gain from this buff by channeling Fleshcraft when needed for some damage reduction, and will especially benefit when enemies don't have an interrupt to stop the channel. As for the Covenant class abilities, we've seen a handful receive some buffs in an attempt to bring representation closer together. However, none of these buffs really stand out as ones that will cause any shift in the best Covenant for each class, at least in PvP. Remember that while Covenant choice in competitive PvE is primarily locked behind numbers, the utility is also a huge consideration in PvP. So just because an ability might get buffed to offer more DPS or HPS, that won't necessarily be enough to bring a change in arena. A great example would be mages, who currently play Night Fae not for the damage it provides them, but for all the insane utility, including the mobility, control, and CD reduction. However, if anything changes and we see players start to switch up their Covenant choice at the highest level, we'll be sure to let you all know in future guides. Alright everyone, that about does it for this one. Hopefully you enjoyed this quick rundown on what's happening next patch. If you did enjoy, remember to like, subscribe, and hit the bell to be notified the moment we release all our upcoming Shadowlands content. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.